his father to fish, so he did not go to school at all. And the Bible says that one day Jesus was preaching around that area. Peter was seeing somebody preaching, but he was less concerned. And I want you this week to be very concerned about what is happening around here. Peter was seeing the people, Jesus preaching together with a team, but he was less concerned. He was just watching his net. The Bible says that when people were, and the people were pushing him to hear the word of God. Can you imagine when everybody is listening to the word of God? Peter was busy washing the net to prepare for the catch of that the following night. But what now connected Peter with Jesus is that Jesus wanted to use the boat because people were pushing to hear Jesus, to hear more about the word. And the Bible says that Peter entered to the boat, Jesus entered the boat that belonged to Peter. And he started preaching when he was steering that boat. And the Bible says, after he heard the word of Jesus Christ, now Jesus told Peter, I have used your boat. Now I want to give you my fish. The boat belonged to Peter because the Bible says the one belonged to the Peter, but fish belonged to God and to Jesus. The natural belongs to you, but supernatural belongs to God. Hey! You can have food, but it is God who gives the appetite. You can have the bed, but it is God who gives the power to sleep. You can have the husband, but it is God who gives the children. You can have money, but it is God who gives the wealthy. I better be wealthy more than having a lot of money. You can have money, but you are confused. But God can make you wealthy. Because that's what the Bible says in Proverbs 10:22, that the blessing of God maketh rich and earneth no sorrow in it. The moment God gives you wealth, he gives you the bed and the power to sleep. He gives you food and the power to enjoy the food. He gives you a home, and also he gives you a house. You can have a house, but you don't have a home. And now Peter was having a boat, but he was not having a fish. He struggled the whole night to get the fish, but the Bible says he caught nothing. If the Bible says he caught nothing, absolutely he caught nothing. But when he allowed Jesus to use his boat, Jesus told Peter, push your boat now to the deep waters and go and let down your net for a catch. It was during the day. Peter said, according to the way we fish, things they are not done that way. But because of the word you have spoken, I will follow the word. And the moment he followed the word and he lowered his net, he caught many fish until the nets were breaking. Hey! Now let me tell you this. He tried to pull his net. Even he decided to call the partners. Hey, God is going to bless you until you have the partner to partner with you. You know, I'm telling you the truth. You don't need to change the lake. You don't need to change the wreck. You need to follow God's provision. You don't need to go to America to be rich. I have not become blessed because I have gone to America. Hey, no way. No way. But God can bless you even where economy is wanting. I want to prophesy to one billionaire here. May God bless you in Uganda. You don't need to change the wreck. You need to change the strategy. Yeah, follow the instructor. You need to follow the instructor. Jesus told Peter, you have been trying the same lake. And because now we are partnering, I'll show you how you change the strategy. Don't fish at night. Today you fish during the day. Hey, that is one strategy. The other strategy, come out of the shallow water. Come out of the shallow prayers. Come out of the shallow giving. Now go to the deep. There in the deep. And he let down your net. And when he did exactly that, he got a lot of fish. Let me tell you, men and women of God, it is easy to take a rich man to heaven. It is easy than to take a poor person into heaven.
Chigumire okukira kutwara umuworo mu iguru. Umugiga na yanguha kugenda konko umuworo ha. Aha.
That's why Jesus said,
Yesu njagirira.
I came to preach the good news to the poor.
Mkiza kubura makuru marunja haworo.
First to deliver the poor person.
Okubanza kayenda ngwa kumuworo gwo muworo.
If you want to see somebody who is ever bitter,
poor person.
A poor person is always bitter. Even if a child can eat a fish or take a glass of milk, you can hear a poor person beating the child thoroughly because of eating alone. Who has taken the milk that was here? Who has eaten the avocado? That is not a language of the rich people. When you take something in the poor family, you are beaten. And maybe a child saw the milk and decided to refresh himself. That is a declared war. But a rich man, when he found his son taking milk, he claps to the
shout.
Thank you for
preaching.
That is the difference between the poor and the rich. When a poor child misplaces a pencil, he loses a pencil in the school. That is a declared war. Where is the pencil? Where is the pencil? That is another war. But when a child of a rich man loses a pencil, the rich man buys another one and tells him, Daddy, take care. It is very hard to hear a wife of a poor person being called honey or a sweetheart.
Just,
it is very hard.
Chigumire.
It is very hard.
Chigumire.
A poor woman to hear a good word called honey, sweetheart, that is the language of the people who are blessed. Everything they They operate like a military.
Burichintu ninkamahe.
They just call the name. Jen, come here.
Hey, you are Jen. Bigaya.
This is my home.
Eje kaneyawe.
I am the owner of this home.
Ninye isheka.
They like proofing themselves.
Nuba kunda kweta hono kwe hamia.
A rich man does not need to prove himself.
Omugiga takwete kuza kwegamba ho byinji.
But a poor person who is the owner of this home.
Konkomoro mukamba weke jinoha.
Proofing and proofing.
Na kakasa na kakasa na kakasa.
Ah, we declare this year. This is the year of action. This is the year of taking another step. We are not going to change the rake. We are going to change the strategy. Change the poverty mentality. We must change the poverty mentality. Let me tell you, church. Unless we change, we will die poor. That's why you see, even people when they are becoming members of parliament or whichever, they still go with the poverty in the parliament and start stealing every ladder everywhere because they are still poor. One of the qualities of a poor people is stealing. They steal the chicken. They steal 10 coins. When they become big people, they start stealing still. Because a poor person believes that he will never have, neither he has not have, he will not have enough, neither have enough. Anytime. But today I want to tell you, church, we are so much blessed. Jesus in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse
9,
Jesus became poor that through his poverty we may become rich. May God make you rich. May God make you millionaires. May God make you billionaire. I break the spirit of poverty. I'm telling you the truth. It is very expensive to handle poverty. The more you become poor, the more you cannot be able to satisfy your family. A poor family, people eat and eat until they eat. And you will never be satisfied. But when you go to a family of a rich man, one bread can be eaten by 6 people. They just eat 2 slices of bread and they are full. But the poor family, even they don't buy the bread, because that is a dessert for a sucking baby. That is a vocabulary. Even they don't buy sugar. Because it cannot be enough. Everybody is eating like a mad person. Can you imagine 6 children of a poor person? They can eat food for 3 or 4 days for the rich people. And they have the same stomach. Poverty is a demon. Poverty is not a fruit of the Holy Spirit. We need to bite every spirit of poverty. Let me tell you, church. The Bible says that when Peter saw the fish, it's not about the word he had that convicted him. It is the supply. The moment he saw the plenty of fish, he knelt down and told Jesus, depart from me. I am a sinful man. And when he was hungry, Jesus was preaching. Jesus was doing miracles, but it was not touching him. What touched Peter is when he saw the fish. We can preach here in Barana, but unless God make you rich, we shall not bring people to the kingdom. I preached when I was poor, and I was calling people to come near in my crusade, and people were just passing there and they were ignoring me. But today, because I am blessed, I don't need to call them so much to come. Even they should tell me, give me your phone number. But there is a time you can have your phone, you are trying to tell people, this is my number, and they are not calling you. Wow.
Hey.
Proverbs 19. I want you to get mad so that you may shift from poverty. You join us in prosperity. Prosperity is not to have a lot of money in the bank. Prosperity is excelling in the Lord in all areas. In the book of Proverbs 19, verse 4. I want you to hate poverty from day. Proverbs 19, verse 4, the Bible says, wealth attracts many friends, but even the closest friend of the poor person deserts them. Imagine the Bible says, wealth attracts many friends. May God make you wealthy in Jesus' name.